Heading back shortly. The buses just got here before the caisson walked around the corner again. So, just a heads up.
Listen, y'all need to come this way so everybody can get off the walkway. Can't be on the walkway. Come on, come on. Come on. Come all the way down. Sir, come all the way down. Come on. All the way down. All the way down. Come stay up. Stay up the walkway. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on.
Just a heads up for guidance. This is the pool out there.
Hi there, buddy. One, two.
Thank you all.
Good morning. In this deeply sorrowful time of loss, I find comfort in being here today with so many loved ones and those who are so lucky to have shared John's warmth and love. I want to begin by thanking the Lewis family. Thank you so much for sharing John with the world. Thank you for accompanying John to Selma one last time. But even more importantly, thank you for sharing him over and over again. Our nation is better off because of John Robert Lewis. My life is better. Selma is better. This nation and this world are better because of John Robert Lewis. So thank you, family. Thank you to his dedicated staff. Thank you to all those who love John. John's love was unique and all-encompassing. It was powerful. You felt it radiate. I miss him dearly, but we are so deeply blessed to have been touched by his greatness. He will forever change Selma and this nation. On Bloody Sunday in 1965, John was confronted by Alabama state troopers and their dogs. They beat him with billy clubs, fracturing his skull. But John was determined to fight for equality and justice, putting his own life on the line in the service of others and a brighter future for everyone. John crossed bridges so many times, insisting that our nation live up to the ideals upon which it was founded. As he always said, he gave a little blood on that bridge. As always, John was humble. His humility rang true. As he takes his final march, that final crossing, John bridged the gaps that so often divided us, our political parties working every day for a more just and equitable America. My heart is full knowing that John is crossing that Selma Bridge today in his final march. His final march, that final crossing, so different from the first, speaks to the legacy that he leaves behind and the lives that he has changed. It's poetic justice that this time, Alabama state troopers will see John to his safety. They will accompany him on his last trip over the Selma Bridge and on to Montgomery, where he will lie in state at the Capitol. John has left this earth, but his legacy remains on. And we continue to benefit from his life's work. He's laid out the blueprint for us to pick up the baton and continue his march for voting rights, for civil rights, for human rights. John believed firmly that the best days of our nation lie ahead of us. I hope his passing causes us to rededicate ourselves to getting into good trouble, necessary trouble. Can't you hear him? Never give up. Never give in. Keep the faith. Keep your eyes on the prize. For John and our nation, let's make him proud.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome gospel recording artist, Kristen Glover.
Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, and let me stand. I am tired, I am weak, and I am worn through the storm and through the night. Lead me on to the light. Take my hand, precious Lord, and lead me on when my way grows drear, precious Lord. Linger near when my life is almost gone.
if you would pray with me. God of our weary years, God of our silent tears, thou who hast brought us thus far on the way, thou who hast by thy might led us into the light, keep us forever in thy path, we pray. Most gracious Father, we come before your presence this morning, reverencing you as our God, understanding that it is you who have made us and not we ourselves, that we are the sheep of your pasture, and it is in you that we live, move, and have our being. We thank you for this day. We thank you for life and another opportunity to serve you this day and live out your purposes in the world. We thank you, Lord, for this occasion as we have assembled ourselves here to give thanks to you for a life well lived. Thank you for Congressman John Lewis. Thank you, Father, for his legacy of being a freedom fighter, his legacy of being a foot soldier for justice, the legacy of being a servant of humanity. As he walked humbly with you, and as he always remembered his roots and always strive so that this world could be a better place, a more equitable world, a world that is more just and more righteous. Thank you for his service to humanity. Thank you, Lord, that he was willing to get in the way. Thank you that he was willing to stir good trouble. Thank you for his voice, the voice that will resonate in our hearts and minds for years and generations to come. Thank you for his message. Thank you, Lord, for using him for such a time as this to bridge divides and help us become a more perfect union. I pray this morning for his family. I pray, Lord, that you will comfort them as only you can, that you will undergird them with your strength and grant them your grace. I pray for your peace that surpasses all understanding to guard their hearts and their minds through Christ Jesus our Lord. And Lord, I pray that we who are still remaining, who still have blood running warm in our veins, that we too will stand for justice, that we will stand for righteousness, that we will lift our voices for you, lift our voices for the cause that is just and right. Until we hear your welcome voice, say, well done, good and faithful servant. As Congressman Lewis crosses the Alabama River, we rejoice today knowing that he's already crossed the Jordan River and he's now resting in your presence. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray and ask all these things. Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes the structured program, but we just have a few notes that we need to give everyone. First and foremost, if we can just show some appreciation to the Congresswoman for helping to put this wonderful program together. And of course, the pastor and the leadership here at the historic Brown Chapel A.M.E. Church. So these announcements are specifically for all of our friends who have joined us this morning. Given that we are still very much in the COVID-19 season, and to ensure the public safety of everyone that wants to be a part of today, we will not have anyone standing on the side of the bridge or crossing the bridge, but there are areas along the route behind the barricades that individuals are more than welcome to stay on the sidewalks behind the barricades to watch the procession if you choose to do so. But we wanted to just let everyone know that logistical piece. Beyond that, we want to thank everyone for joining us and ask that you please continue to lift up and keep the Lewis family in your thoughts and prayers. God bless and have a wonderful and blessed day.
Thank you.
Yep, I got it.
No, no, oh my God. I got it. You want me to put it on the, put it on?
Or, yeah. Or next to it. Funny. I'm smiling inside.
Should I move back?
No, we have not reached it. Yes, we'll give you a warning.
Okay, I got the shot. Back up.
We're back up. Yes, we're locked in the pit.
Thank you.
Hold. Left wheel. Left side steps. March.
All the buses are about to go. Stay right. They're about to go. Yeah, they're about to go.
I mean, we can walk this way over here.
All right, I'm switching over to camera and mic now.
I'm gonna bring you down.
Don't, not yet, not yet.
they're going to stop right here because they're right here, right? Is that what the plan was?
I guess. I came down here because they put the cone there, and the young lady said that's where it's going to stop. So I was set up. You saw her, I was set up further up. I was just guessing.
Yeah.
And then when I saw the cone in the middle of the road, that's when I asked her, like,
yeah.
Is that what's happening? She said yes, so that's why I moved in.
Well, I'm worried because they said that we could go around them when they stopped, so if it's up there, everybody's going to be revealed. Oh, okay, okay.
I can get right over it.
got stuff on all four numbers.
Nice.
As well it should be.
The best one.
Right.
The best one. This is the shop.
I'm probably, well, whenever they get here, whenever they get here, probably just from the horse to the head.
Yeah,
and I'll just go by when they start moving. So yeah, when they start moving, I'm going to pan and go all the way with them. Now. That's when I really start yelling. I'm really not that good. I'm really lucky in my level.
You got it from here, sir.
here.